Hello folks, this is Vikas Bagel and today I want to share with you how I prepared for my placement and cracked Google off campus. Before diving deep, let me give you a brief intro about myself. I'm currently working at Google as a software engineer. I have done my bachelor's and master's in electrical engineering from IIT BHU and graduated in 2021. बहुत लोगों ने मेरे से पूछा है कि मैंने Google के लिए कैसे preparation start करी, कहाँ से की, क्या-क्या पढ़ा मैंने. So I thought of making a video explaining my preparation journey. We will start from very basic and step by step learn how to build a strong foundation. मेरी तरह आप में से कई सारे लोग ऐसे होंगे जिनको स्कूल के टाइम प्रोग्रामिंग का ज़्यादा एक्सपोजर नहीं मिला होगा. So the first step is to learn object oriented programming language. Some of the popular OOPS languages are Java, Python, C++. You can choose any one of them. I was comfortable with C++. Because it is very similar to C, which I studied during my first year. And also, C++ is considered faster for competitive programming. You need to master any one language of your choice, as all languages differ only in syntax, which can be learned in a week or so. After you have had a fair understanding of the language, the next step is to learn DSA, that is, data structures and algorithms. I learned data structures and algo from YouTube and Geeks for Geeks, which is also known as GFG. On YouTube, you can find a channel called My Code School. It has a playlist on data structure, which has about 42 videos explaining the concepts very clearly. And on GFG, there is a data structure section where you can find 10 to 15 standard questions on each topic. First, I used to watch the videos on YouTube, understand the concept, and then see the implementation on GFG. After understanding it, I used to try to code on my own. Some of you might get frustrated at the beginning, seeing slower progress, but it's all right. No need to worry about it. During my initial days, I also struggled a lot and used to take a lot of time in finding the errors. But the consistent efforts helped me overcome it. So the more time you will spend practicing, the easier this course will become for you. मैं अपनी बात करूं तो मैंने हर टॉपिक से 10 टू 15 क्वेश्चन किए थे और एक बेसिक अंडरस्टैंडिंग बना ली थी कि हाउ डेटा स्ट्रक्चर वर्क्स. बट आई वॉज अनेबल टू अप्लाई दीज कॉन्सेप्ट्स इन द क्वेश्चन. मैनी पीपल फेस द सेम डिफिकल्टी दैट दे अंडरस्टैंड द वर्किंग ऑफ डेटा स्ट्रक्चर्स बट आर नॉट एबल टू इनकॉर्पोरेट इट इन क्वेश्चन. सो माई सजेशन वुड बी टू स्टार्ट सॉल्विंग टॉपिक वाइज क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम लीड कोड. In LeetCode, you can sort the questions based on level of difficulty. First, I solved few easy questions, and once I was able to tackle them, I moved to medium and difficult questions. On difficult questions, I did not spend more than 45 to 60 minutes. If I was stuck, I used to move to the discussion forum. There, I used to understand other people's code and would write down their technique or style which I found interesting and then try to solve the problem again. This was just a brief explanation. I will be making another video explaining how to use various websites efficiently like LeetCode, InterviewBit, GFG, CodeForces, CodeChef and many more. Now my favorite part, competitive program. ये समझना जरूरी है कि interview में accuracy और speed दोनों देखी जाती है. So to improve my speed, I participated regularly in competitive programming contests hosted by various platforms like CodeForces, CodeChef, AdCoder and many more. It is necessary to solve the problems after the contest is over. My suggestion would be that you try to solve the problems on your own, and when you have implemented all your ideas and are completely stuck, then only move to the discussion forum and see other people's solution. Seeing other people's solution will help you in learning many new things and tricks that you might not be aware of. Though data structure and algorithm are the most important topics for clearing the online assessment test and interviews for any company, there are other topics that you have to give equal attention to as they are frequently asked in the interviews. OOPS concepts are very important for interviews as well as online assessment tests. I prepared the OOPS concept from GFG and started reading the articles. If there is some topic that you are not able to understand from the article, just search it on YouTube or Google you will definitely find some explanation. If you want to be in software field, you should have a strong understanding of operating system. I prepared this course from OS course notes. Just type OS course notes in the search bar and click on the first link having notes. If you prefer the video mode of content, you can look at many playlists available on YouTube. The next topic is networking. I did not have much time to prepare for networking, so I ended up watching the networking playlist by Gates Smashers. You can research a bit and find other playlists if you want to. There is a book on networking by Forozon that will help you in deeper understanding of the topic. If you have time, I would definitely recommend you to give it a read. Some of the interviewers might ask you to solve puzzles to check your ability to think under pressure. It's kind of like a stress test to check your logical ability and presence of mind. Many times we are nervous during the interviews and are not able to solve a very basic puzzle. So it's always good to practice some puzzles for the interview so that you have a fair idea about what might be asked. I would suggest you to look at the puzzle section of GFG. There are about 44 puzzles that you can easily solve. Just practice 6 to 7 puzzles daily. It would hardly take an hour or so, and you will be able to finish it in a week. Some companies ask probability questions during their online assessment. We all have studied probability during our second and third year, but let's accept the truth. We have forgotten it after our final exams. So there's a very good article on CodeShip that nicely explains the concept of expectation. I would recommend you to read it once. Other than that, you can revise some basic probability formulas like normal distribution, standard deviation, etc. Before going to the interview, it is very important to read about other people's interview experiences. It will help you in understanding what type of questions are being asked by that particular company. Sometimes the questions are repeated by the interviewer because usually there is a bank of questions from which they ask. I used to read about the interview experiences from GFG. Just Google search X company interview experience and you will get the result. Many companies include an aptitude section in their online assessment to check the general caliber of the student. I would suggest you to solve questions from RS Agrawal book. Just solve a few questions from every topic to brush up your concepts. Thank you guys for watching. I hope this gave you a brief overview of how I prepared for my placement and cracked Google off campus. I will be making more videos where I will dive deeper and share with you how to prepare various topics, how to efficiently use various coding platforms, and I will be also sharing my interview experience. If you like the video, please like, share and subscribe and press the bell icon to get notification every time I upload a new video. Thank you.